How important is finasteride in treating male pattern hair loss?
Many men with male pattern hair loss have reservations about taking finasteride as part of a strategy to manage male pattern hair loss. I'll discuss how I make recommendations about finasteride in my practice. I'm Dr. Amiya Prasad. I'm a board-certified cosmetic surgeon and fellowship-trained oculofacial plastic and reconstructive surgeon. I've been in practice in Manhattan and Long Island for over 20 years. I'm also the founder of TrichoStem Hair Regeneration Centers, which evolved from the work we did using a material called extracellular matrix with platelet-rich plasma for hair transplant surgery and is now a highly successful non-surgical treatment for male and female pattern hair loss patients who come to us from around the world. Finasteride is a drug that inhibits the enzyme 5-alpha reductase, which is responsible for converting the hormone testosterone to dihydrotestosterone, or DHT. Hair follicles sensitive to DHT will progressively thin and eventually disappear. This drug has been on the market since 1997. As a surgeon performing hair transplants, I have prescribed this drug to help my patients slow down their hair loss progression and delay their need for additional hair transplant surgery. In my experience, it has been an effective drug for most male pattern hair loss patients. In clinical practice, we found ourselves in an interesting position in 2011. At the time, we had been using a stem cell-based wound healing material with PRP, or platelet-rich plasma, to help our patients' hair transplant have better healing of the donor area and improve the survivability of hair grafts. A side effect was seen a year or so later, where thinning non-transplanted hair became thicker. This inspired me to develop a way to help men and women with genetic pattern hair loss without surgery. TrichoStem Hair Regeneration is an injection treatment using platelet-rich plasma, or PRP, which is taken from your own blood and a wound healing material called acellular matrix or extracellular matrix. The treatment clinically appears to thicken thinning hair, reactivate hairs which have been not growing, and extend the hair growth cycle. With only one injection treatment session, patients were able to achieve significantly better scalp coverage. Effectively, we helped establish a new category in the treatment of hair loss, which had not been done since the introduction of finasteride in 1997. At the time, there was a growing concern about sexual side effects caused by the drug finasteride. This resulted in most male patients coming to us to have TrichoStem hair regeneration treatment without taking finasteride. The level of consistent success with TrichoStem hair regeneration without finasteride made me question the relative importance of this drug. As time went on, we treated more patients and gained more clinical data. Periodically, we treat a patient with hair regeneration and did not see a benefit. I placed these patients on finasteride and performed another injection, resulting in improvement. I reviewed my results of patients who were already on finasteride and saw significant improvement with TrichoStem hair regeneration. Eventually, it became clear that the mechanism of hair growth related to finasteride was different from the mechanism related to TrichoStem hair regeneration. With more data, I developed a classification system for the hair regeneration treatment, where I factor current age, age of onset of hair loss, degree of hair loss, and other treatments like finasteride or hair transplant in addition to other medical factors. I determine during consultation whether someone has low, moderate, or high DHT sensitivity and make recommendations accordingly. I routinely provide my patients with a treatment plan which gives my patients an understanding of their classification and what I would recommend for them for best results. Over the years since 2011, I've observed how stable the benefits of TrichoStem hair regeneration has been. Most people have had improvement lasting 3 to 5 years with only one treatment. Recognizing that some people have shorter hair growth cycles, particularly when hair loss is more advanced, a second injection, referred to as a booster, is provided at 15 to 18 months. DHT sensitivity is an important factor to manage in hair loss treatment, and the risks of finasteride remain controversial on the internet. Clinically, I have been prescribing finasteride particularly for patients who are classified as highly sensitive to DHT. The synergy of finasteride combined with TrichoStem hair regeneration has made a significant impact on helping my patients with male pattern hair loss. I hope you found this information helpful. Thank you for your question.